Hey guys, welcome to the exciting tutorial of creating process, and today's video we'll be designing this logo. If you observe this logo carefully, you can see that the overall design is forming a part of spiral spring. Four rectangles has been used and has been revolved over a cylinder to form this shape, and after that each piece has been given some thickness to create a sense of depth. So let's create this design. First, to create this design, I will create a strip of rectangle by selecting the rectangle tool and creating a strip of rectangle. Let's give this some simple color like black and duplicate this four times by clicking Alt and mouse click drag. After you have created four strips of rectangle, just ensure that their spacing between each of them are equal. So just adjust it. Now select the object, go to symbol and drag this object inside this. In this way you can create this object into symbol form. Name this like rectangle strip, strip strip, and click OK. And after that you can delete this part. Now the next step is to create a cylinder. To create a cylinder, we'll use a rectangle and make out a strip of it. Now this is our cylinder. Using this, we'll create a cylinder by using the 3D options. So select this object, make it a little bit more thinner like this. Select this object, go to effect 3D and revolve. This option will create this strip into, convert this into 3D object like a cylindrical. So you can preview it like it's cylinder. Now just give everything zero, change every value into zero, and after that we will want to tilt this into 90 degree angle. So I'll go this to this and put 90 degree and click OK. So we want this object to be this, like this, and if we go inside like map art, you got this option. Ensure that we need this surface, like the surface which is revolving, and in that we will put our symbol strip. And if you want to see this, just make it invisible geometry. It will convert the object into geometrical form, and after that you can just rotate this part and you can see the design forming here. You can just adjust it if you want and click OK. And once you've got that, if you're ready with that, click OK. So we got our basic design which we want for this logo to be prepared. After that, just click this, go to object, expand appearance, and here ungroup it, and after that select this and release clipping mask. Now each object is separate. Select this one and release clipping mask, and delete the clipping objects by selecting it like this. Selected. Okay, now after that we'll select this object. We want to form this like N, so we'll just drag this and place it after this. We'll duplicate this one more time and by clicking Alt and drag and place it in the correct position. So we got our overall shape like this. Now we need a little bit of height, so let's scale this up a little bit. After that, the next step is to bring these two pieces and arrange it to the front so that these two pieces are above and this is below. And after that, select these pieces and let's give some lighter color so that it can be easily visible. Now select this piece overall, go to effect 3D and extrude and bevel. This will give some thickness to the object. So let's put all the value to zero and preview it. Now let's give some perspective around 10, some thickness, extrude depth thickness around 106. Let's change this angle to around plus 4, and just play with the extrude options. Once you are happy with it, the extrude depth, click OK. In the same way, we'll select this, go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel. Here, convert all the values to 0. And after that, in the perspective, let's give some perspective to 10 or maybe 11. It's okay. In the preview option, click the preview option and now increase the depth to around 100 or maybe this much. That we will correct it later. Just give this angle to -3 or -4. -4, and in the extrude, just adjust the depth. And after that, click OK. Our next step, lag step, is we will select this, go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel, and here we'll convert all the values to 0. Let's give the same perspective around, maybe we need more perspective angles. We'll just keep it for a while, extrude it to, and you can preview it. Now we will just play with the perspective and extrude option, so just keep on editing. Just see which. Now after that, we'll just reduce the depth. We can increase or reduce it. Let's reduce the perspective angle and let's see what happens. So you got the depth here. Here you can increase or decrease by using the extrude depth. Once you got that, you can click OK. So we have created our basic design. Now the next step is to give some gradient color, and for to do that, I have already created two strip of gradient color. I have created this two pieces for different use, so we'll use these pieces to fill up our color. In the earlier tutorials, I already told that I usually find all the colors which I need and then just place it here so that it makes our work easier. So let's ungroup it first. Go to select everything, go to object and expand appearance. This will convert everything into object form. Now ungroup it. In the same way, select this, ungroup it. And in the same way, select this and ungroup it. So everything is now, I think, separate. Each pieces are separate. Now we'll select all these upper surfaces, like this one, this, 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 and this. And with the eye picker, by eye clicking it, select this color. And with the gradient tool, just adjust the color. Now after that, we'll select the depth pieces, that's the thickness. Select everything. And select the, with the eye picker, select the same color, and with the gradient tool, just adjust it. Now we will do for the inner version too. We'll select this, this one, this, and this. With the eye picker, we'll select this color, and with the gradient tool, just apply it. Now after that, we are left with this that thickness pieces. So select it carefully, pieces which are creating thickness. And now we'll select with the eye picker, we'll select this color, and with the gradient tool, just adjust the reflection. Ensure that the glossiness is down there and darkness is above. So in this way, we have created our, we have given the gradient color also, and after that you can see that the overall look is like glossy and it's like 3D. Now if you see that the height is quite lower, you can select everything, you can group it, Control G, and scale it up a little bit more. Our next step is to create the text. So we'll go to text. Here we'll write an EURON neuron. We'll duplicate this one and type ESTAPLISHAT striplist 2014, and I'll scale this down and place it below there. Zoom in and place it properly in the center. Now I'll select this one and place it properly. If it's small, just scale it up, place it, and last thing is I'll convert this object into text into object. So I'll go to object, expand. This will convert this text into object, and we can easily fill the colors which we want. So we'll just this color with the gradient tool, just apply it properly. You can see it. Now after that, next step is we'll just lighten this up. We'll give some gray color, light gray color, and click OK. Now the last, we'll need some background color, so I'll select this piece and duplicate this and place it there and just scale this up. So this is how we can create this logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and for more designing tips and tricks, click the subscribe button. Thank you.